Hey YouTube, welcome to Joe's RC Pit. I haven't made a video in a while, and I apologize for that, but I just wanted to show you this because I could not find a video for this online anywhere, and this is a pretty big deal, I think. So I got this VIC20 computer online, and it came with this nice cassette drive, but the person that packed it put the cassette drive on top of the keyboard without bubble wrap, and then, you know, FedEx did the rest, and it came in with all these keys damaged, which originally was not damaged when I saw the unit online. So what happened was is these little posts inside broke off the keys like that, and then the force was hitting the key so hard it actually snapped off the piece. And then so you see there's a little piece of plastic in here. Well, how do we get that out of there? Because these are wedged in pretty tight, and if you've seen some videos online of them trying to pull these off, they have these little wire things that go up underneath there, and they really got to yank on them to get them off. So those aren't going to come out easy. And I couldn't find a video anywhere online, so I thought, well, I'll make one and show you guys how it's done. You can go on Amazon and get yourself one of these little drill kits and one of these little handheld drill presses, fairly cheap. And what you do is you go into the bottom of the key here, and you take this and you turn it in kind of on an angle like that until you get a hole started in the middle. Then you straighten it out and you go straight down until you get yourself a nice hole. Then you go ahead and I used one of these, but if you have a small screw set, this is from an 18 scale RC18T, and inside here you've got some really nice tiny screws and some wrenches and so forth to put those in. And what you end up doing is, after you drill the hole, is you put a small screw into the key like this, using the little tool that comes with the kit. And then after that is in there, you take yourself a pair of pliers and you just put it underneath the head of the screw and you just give it a little tug and out it pops. And there you go. Now you got your key ready. And then you can order these on eBay or somewhere online, these separate keys. There's tons of guys out there with keyboard parts that are selling these. I think it was $5 for three of them. And that's it. Then when they come in, you put them in the keyboard, then you can snap your keys back on, and then you'll have a working keyboard again. Thanks for watching.